Lenovo's 8th generation Legion Slim 7i is a seriously impressive laptop for its size. It strikes the right balance between performant parts and a keen awareness that it's still a laptop. Special thanks to the folks at Lenovo and Intel who sponsored this video and gave us a chance to put this through its paces. We're gonna talk about what made it so special and share how it almost walked out of the studio before we could record this video. Seriously, he just kept saying the words, it was precious to him. My precious. Maybe I exaggerated just a little. No, you don't have to worry about your friends and family falling into a jealous trance, or that this laptop will somehow slip from your fingers into the hands of a new master
and then take over the world.
Our team, however, was just really impressed by Lenovo's Legion Slim 7i, and we all found things, you know what, we absolutely loved about it. Not only was it stunningly performant, but it was also thinner and lighter than several laptops we've tested. Not to mention that it has a starting price of $1,449.99. It's a solid buy all around, especially when we look at the whole picture. Okay, that is some lofty praise, so let's take a closer look. At first glance, the Legion Slim lives up to its name. It measures in at 14.08 inches or 357.7 millimeters wide, 10.2 inches or 259.3 millimeters deep, and 0.69 inches or 17.6 millimeters tall. And it only weighs 4.4 pounds or just under 2 kilograms. But don't let its weight fool you. This thing has a high quality feel to it, thanks to its sleek aluminum shell, and it's packing some modest hardware inside too. The Legion Slim 7i we reviewed has the Intel Core i7-13700H at its heart. This CPU is built on Intel's hybrid architecture with 6P or performance cores or 8E or efficiency cores with speeds up to 5 gigahertz. The Intel Core i7-13700H also benefits from features like Intel's Thread Director to pair the right application to the right core and 24 megabytes of Intel Smart Cache, which is shared dynamically across CPU cores. Both of these features can really help game performance, especially if you're multitasking while gaming or streaming, or gaming and streaming. As for the GPU, our configuration has NVIDIA's RTX 4060 mobile version with 8 gigabytes of VRAM, powering a 16-inch 1600p display. Essentially, it's a 1440p, but it's got bonus real estate. Now, this IPS display has a refresh rate of 240 hertz and a brightness of 500 nits. The Legion Slim's display also covers 100% of the sRGB color spectrum and is equipped with NVIDIA's G-Sync technology. For storage, our model was a little lean with only 512 gigabytes of storage, but there is a 1 terabyte model, which, oddly enough, is available at the price we listed above, which is weird, but good, and the one that you more than likely want. If you wanted to add an NVMe drive, and you probably will need to if you grab the 512 gigabyte version, it's very easy to do so without any specialized tools other than a small Phillips head screwdriver. As for system memory, the Legion Slim 7i has 16 gigabytes of DDR5 RAM running at 5200 megatransfers. These memory modules are soldered to the motherboard, but there is also a single SODIMM that is available if you want to upgrade to 32 gigabytes of RAM. Adding RAM required a few more steps than adding another NVMe drive, but it too was decently straightforward once we did a little research. And guess what? We're going to show you that a little bit later. When it comes to external connectivity, the Legion Slim 7i has 3 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type A ports, 1 USB-C Gen 2 3.2 Type 2 port, 1 HDMI with support up to 4K 60, 1 Thunderbolt 4 port, woohoo! Wi-Fi 6E, Bluetooth 5.1, a card reader, and a partridge in a pear tree. It also has a 1080p webcam with Tobii Horizon eye tracking support and a handy dandy off switch. And finally, a multifunction audio jack. Sadly, it does not have onboard Ethernet, which is a little bit of a bummer. What isn't a bummer though, is that Lenovo puts lights on the back of this thing so you don't have to struggle to figure out where your plugs are in the dark. It is so cool, and honestly, we actually really geeked out about it. I don't know why anybody else hasn't thought of this. Now, the Lenovo 7i is also equipped with Lenovo's LA2-Q AI chip to help with smart overclocking and intelligently boosting performance while running more demanding applications. The Lenovo Legion Slim 7i is backed by 1 year of 24/7 tech support, as well as parts and labor warranty that covers shipping or at-your-doorstep support. This warranty can be extended for up to 4 years. And honestly, my thing, 2-3 years is always a really good idea. Speaking of extend, if you want to extend your education while sharing some laughs along the way, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you don't miss out on future reviews like this one and miss really precious hardware. Now, let's take a look at the Legion Slim 7i and how it performed at 1440p in our gaming benchmarks, because at its heart, it is a gaming laptop. In Cyberpunk 2077, running ray tracing, ultra settings with DLSS set to balance, we saw an average frame rate of 41.13 FPS. Now, while this doesn't hit 60 FPS, Cyberpunk is still enjoyable and playable, but with a few minor tweaks, the Slim 7i can get a whole lot closer to that mark. In Forza Horizon 5, at extreme settings with DLSS set to balance, the Legion Slim ran at a very blistering 96 frames per second. Moving on to Modern Warfare 2, on ultra settings with DLSS set to balance, Lenovo's Legion Slim 7i gave us frame rates of 100 frames per second, which that makes me excited, especially given that beautiful screen. In Shadow of the Tomb Raider, the Legion ran at 129 frames per second at the highest preset with DLSS also set to balance. In Tiny Tina's Wonderland, with graphics settings set to badass and FSR 2.0 set to balance, we saw averages of 88.22 frames per second. In competitive titles like Apex Legends, with visual settings set to low, basically maximizing frame rate, we got an average FPS of 141.8. And finally, in Fortnite again, with low settings at DLSS enabled at balance, we saw a frame rate average of 270.4. Now, quick stop here real quick. If you're thinking, Robey, what am I gonna use that 240 hertz screen for? You got games like Fortnite, CSGO 2, and of course Valorant, which are gonna have no issue having and using that beautiful fast screen. Now, while running these tests, we did collect data on thermal performance of the Lenovo Legion Slim. What we saw was really impressive for such a small and very thin laptop. At idle, the Intel Core i7-13700H rested at a low temperature of 52 degrees Celsius. Under full CPU load, the Legion Slim kept comparatively cool at an average of 78 degrees Celsius. Finally, in our gaming benchmarks, the Lenovo Legion Slim CPU held steady at 70 degrees Celsius. And thanks to sensors on the GPU, which, guys, we test a lot of these laptops and we don't always get this level of sensor array. So huge shout out to Lenovo for giving us so much that we could measure. But anyway, the RTX 4060 barely broke a sweat at 65 degrees Celsius. Now, while we ran these tests, like all of the other laptops, on an open bench and elevator for max airflow, we also did some gaming with this laptop sitting on our laptop. Like you should. Now, though, while this wouldn't be great for the laptop itself long-term, because the air intake is of course located on the bottom, it didn't get overly warm, which is amazing because no one wants an easy bake oven on their lap. So with all of that in mind, you're probably asking, Robey, what was it like to actually use the Lenovo Legion Slim 7i? Like I said in the opening, we were really impressed with what we saw, but we have to talk about the overall experience using it. As gaming laptops go, the Lenovo Legion Slim 7i doesn't beat you over the head with its aesthetic. It's not screaming, hey, we got a gaming laptop here. Hey guys, look at me, look. But that's not what this was doing. Now, while the keyboard does have per key RGB lighting, if you don't know any better, this looks more like an enterprise class ultrabook. That though is when it hit us. When we looked at the hardware, battery life, and even the keyboard layout, which includes a 10 key keypad, this laptop could be the perfect middle ground between professional work and gaming. And since we're talking about it here, we really need to talk about some productivity numbers. We don't usually get into these with gaming laptops, but because of how this laptop rides that line of gaming performance and professional appearance, it's only appropriate that we drop those details here. When we compare this to laptops like the Surface Laptop Studio 2, which is very productivity and creator focus, or the Asus ROG Strix G16, which you could consider business casual, the Lenovo Legion Slim 7i not only holds its own, but it also excelled. See what I did there? It edged out the productivity focused Surface by an overall average of 6.6% in PC Mark 10, while falling ever so slightly behind the G16 by around 1.7%. However, we moved to a more real-world benchmark, ALUL Procyon, expanding into testing performance in the entire Office suite, including Microsoft Outlook. Yes, we're talking about email productivity at this point, guys. The margin between the Legion Slim and the Surface was about 0.4% in favor of the Lenovo, which we could consider a rounding error, so we'll call it a tie, but it did take a 4% lead over the Asus laptop. Not only did it perform well in both gaming and productivity, but the Legion Slim is not as loud as some of the other gaming laptops we've tested. Now, to be fair, the 13th gen Core i7 and the RTX 4060 are far less demanding than hardware like a Core i9 or an RTX 4090. However, this modest pairing of components makes a fantastic choice for a lightweight laptop. While we are talking about it, we have to talk about fan noise here because that can honestly make or break an experience with me. In fact, I've used some incredibly powerful, incredibly awesome laptops that are so loud that it just makes me not want to. The Legion Slim has three fan modes with a color indicator around the power button. Blue is whisper mode, white is auto mode, where the fans adjust based on use, and boost mode, which is only available when the laptop is plugged in, is red. Because we all know, thanks to the wisdom of orcs and Warhammer 40K, that red ones go faster. The Legion Slim 7i was noticeably quiet while gaming, and that was while fans were running in boost mode. Under CPU load, the loudest it got was 59.4 decibels, which is roughly the volume of a normal conversation or the sound of an air conditioner. Not the sound of my voice right now, which is probably coming in at a booming 9 million decibels. We mentioned this earlier, but it's worth bringing up again, especially if you're looking to spend money on a laptop. When it comes to the ease of use of upgrading this laptop, the Lenovo Legion Slim 7i is probably one of the easiest laptops that we have seen to upgrade, especially when it comes to adding an additional NVMe drive. A few screws on the back cover and you're right where you need to be. We did, however, have one consideration we need to point out when it comes to upgrading the RAM. There was what we think is a thermal pad adhered to the CPU and GPU cooler that we had to peel back ever so slightly in order to get to the SODIMM slot enclosure. We were very careful doing this and it was still fairly quick too. However, had we not been cautious, damaging this pad or reattaching it poorly could change how the Legion Slim handles cooling. And we know that too much heat can have a negative impact on performance overall. And no one wants that. What we do want is more time with this laptop because I haven't even talked about the display yet. Because its rich depth of color, high resolution, and high refresh rate make it an absolute treat to use, whether gaming or even getting your work done. Seriously, if I've said this once, I will say it a million times. 1440p or 1600p in this case displays with a 240 hertz refresh rate are my favorite displays. And that's just because honestly, it doesn't take crazy powerful hardware to push it and it makes the hardware inside of the laptop just last so much longer. Now, one more experience piece that I want to mention here, and this may be only relevant to a small number of you watching, is that I asked Damien, our lead writer, about his experience using the Legion Slim versus the MacBook Pro. Don't hate on him. He's one of those people that uses and appreciates both systems. They are traders. His take was this. If you put aside the differences in operating system and ecosystem, the experience, it felt very familiar from an elemental standpoint. The solid aluminum design, the keyboard, and the touchpad on the Legion Slim 7i, as odd as it sounds, all made Damien feel right at home when using it. Now, this is coming from a guy who has traveled a lot with a crusty old 15-inch MacBook Pro, and that familiarity and dependability is really important for Damien to keep that creative flow of writing going strong. Now, Damien might feel differently if he were using a more current MacBook, but if Damien was gonna buy a laptop today, and he even said this, on a $1,500 budget, I think Damien would be hard-pressed to find an option on either side of the OS aisle that ticked as many boxes for him that the Legion Slim 7i did. So there you have it. Is Damien gonna retire that old MacBook 15 and switch? Well, the world may never know. But then I guess if the laptop goes missing, then we know who to go track down, Brian. Now, looking at our experience with the 8th generation Lenovo Legion Slim 7i, we found this configuration to be a fantastic blend of performance and efficiency. If you do need a little bit more power out of the laptop, the Legion Slim 7i is available in configurations with up to a Core i9-13900H and an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4070, which makes sense given just the thin enclosure. And again, I don't think they want this to make a ton of sound. They really want to make this a very useful laptop for pretty much anybody getting it. Here's it down in a nutshell. It handled everything that we needed it to do and then some. If you're looking for a well-built laptop that can bridge the gap between work and play, then you know what? The 7i is definitely worth considering. Now, those are our impressions of the Lenovo Legion Slim 7i, but we wanna know what you think. Let us know in the comments below. And while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button with that like button and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here at Robeytech. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching this video and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.